My name is Patience Spanda, and I'll be mainly presenting on why Bulawayo is a special place. So I'll be touching mainly on the human activities and how they influence climate change in the area and how we can better actually like come up with solutions to the problems that are being faced in the area. So mainly Bulawayo is in the region that mainly focuses on cattle ranching because of the amount of rainfall that is actually received in the area, which does not support the growing of other crops. So mainly just focuses on cattle ranching. And then so like looking at the climate conditions in the area, you find that on average the warmest months are January, and we have October and also November, and then we have like the rain season, which is January, February and December, and having December is the wettest, and then we have the dry season being May, June, July, August, September. So like you find that in Bulawayo we experience almost all the type of seasons, and but having the rain season as the longest in the area. So now moving into the ecological system in Bulawayo. So you'd find that in Bulawayo, like okay, so firstly it is dominated by woodlands. Like the area is mainly dominated by woodlands, and these woodlands actually are found both in high density suburbs and also in low density suburbs, right? So so when it comes to earth system sciences, you find that woodland ecosystem are integral and crucial in to biodiversity and also neighboring human communities. So you find that these ecosystems have experienced changes in their physical nature, and yeah, which affect the role that they can actually play. So like looking at an urban setup where we have issues to do with urban expansion, also the wood fuel collection, also issues to do with agriculture. And then also like in this era where we have the advent of the open air churches, so this has actually led into the clearing of these particular woodlands. So to a greater extent I can conclude that the era is slowly losing the woody vegetation, right? So then we also move on. So this is the first human activity, and then we also go on to the second activity, which becomes the artisanal small scale mining that is also practiced around the region, right? So you find that artisanal mining, I can tell that it is a sustainable activity that is practiced by people to meet their short-term survival needs. So this becomes an economic issue that then boils down to environmental effects, right? Because now people, this is a way of them to actually achieve their needs, and they cause siltation in rivers, which later affects all life forms that are found in those rivers if they're to dry up because of siltation, and also it affects the carrying capacity of dams that actually affect by those particular rivers. So these are all the problems that are actually being faced in the area. So then to a greater extent, why I would say it is important to study science and systems in Bulawayo, it is mainly because with all the effects that I've actually mentioned, the human activities, to a greater extent, this actually allows us to actually come up with climate models that can actually be useful in actually coming up with solutions that can help not only Bulawayo, but rather the country and the region and any other country that also has the same human activities that are affecting the environment to a greater extent. So that's why I'll say that the study of soil vegetation, atmosphere and its impacts, right, actually allow us to actually allow the creation of models, right, which provide useful insight into earth system functions. And also like you find that climate models are actually useful with agricultural and economic models, provide a broader view of earth systems and help us in creating concepts of sustainable development for all aspects of human life on earth. So we find that the human activities that I've mentioned together with natural changes in earth systems that are actually important compartments of earth systems. So I think that is why then it is important to actually come and study this in Bulawayo. So then when we move to culture, you find that in the area there's the issue that they have to be the protection of wetlands, and also the wildfires are like something that you cannot do because of the effects that they have on the environment. So basically we say that both the municipality and the residents have a role to play in environmental protection. So it is not necessarily the municipality that have to do all the job. So everyone in the area knows that it is their role to actually protect the environment. So yeah, Also, even if there is cold panning, people are also taught that they're supposed to avoid saltation because of the effects that they have in the environment. So overall, I think Bulawayo is a unique place, and it is important for us to actually study in system sciences there, because it can actually help us come up with the models that will be useful for us to actually achieve sustainable development. Thank you.